Aston Villa's under-23s are bidding to reach the Premier League Cup final this evening. Kevin MacDonald's team have enjoyed a wonderful season and faced their biggest test tonight against Leicester City. The Foxes pushed Arsenal close for the Premier League 2 Division 1 title and head into the match against the Villans as favourites. But Villa have beaten Blackburn Rovers, who pipped them to the Division 2 title, and Middlesbrough in dramatic fashion to reach the semi-final stage. Leicester and Villa met in the final of the Hong Kong Soccer Sevens tournament last summer, where the Foxes prevailed 3-0 victors. Callum O'Hare and co. go in search of revenge this evening as they look to complete what would be a memorable promotion and cup double. The playoffs are on hold for now as the Place Cup takes center stage at the King Power tonight. Kickoff is at 7 p.m. and you can follow the action live right here. 2126 KEY event. Maybe we spoke too soon. Thomas fires into the far corner to reduce the arrears. 21-24 Kevin Thepburn Murphy, who had missed a similar chance moments earlier, picks the ball up and dances past Leicester's last man before smashing home left-footed. Villa are going to the Premier League Cup final. 21-22 O'Hare picks up a booking for kicking the ball away. A little harsh in the grand scheme of things. 21-18 Villa lead 2-1 thanks to that RHM strike. It will be a very quick turnaround here, so stay tuned. 21-11 Villa second change sees Blackett Taylor, who assisted Clark's opener, replaced by Jordan Cox. 21-09 first change for Villa is Baisley Graham, who set up Hepburn Murphy's goal, is replaced by Oscar Borg. Clark will come across to right back and Borg will play at left back. 21-06 key event Villa are back in front. Baisley Graham brings the ball out and fires a lovely ball over Ben Lewain's head for Hepburn Murphy to latch onto, round the keeper and stroke home. Excellent work by the young right back and RHM. Villa lead 2-1. 21-04 we're back underway here. A big 30 minutes, and maybe penalties, needed from Villa. 20-58 key event extra time it is. The game has livened up in the final 15 minutes as Clark's brilliant goal is cancelled out by 31-year-old Johan Benelouane. 20-52 the free kick comes to nothing and Villa break away through O'Hare. Villa's midfielder is fouled by Dewsbury Hall, who gets booked. O'Hare tries to get the ball back and it all kicks off. Lydon was walking over and was walloped on the back by Musque. The referee couldn't have missed it but no action seems to have been taken. 20-50 key event wow, the referee gave Leicester a penalty after Sarkic brought down Musque but O'Hare argued the challenge was outside the box and the decision has been reversed. Leicester are livid as Sarkic breathes a huge sigh of relief. 20-41 key event Leicester are level as substitute Leandro Martis crosses for Benelouane at the far post to head home. 20-36 key event that was sensational. O'Hare picks the ball up out on the left and plays a 1-2 with Clark before giving it to Doyle Hayes who sends it to Blackett Taylor on the right, he fires it across and Clark stabs home. Around 16 minutes to go and Villa lead 1-0. What a goal. 20-32 Leicester have just made their second chance with Admiral Musque replacing Josh Appiah. Villa are yet to make a change of their own. 20-30 Villa are beginning to exploit weaknesses in the Foxes, particularly down the right. Clark just teed up O'Hare but Everson spectacularly denied him the opener. 20-26 that was a huge chance for RHM. He picked the ball up deep and used runs from O'Hare and Baisley Graham as decoys before wriggling free and firing over. That was the best chance either team has had. 20-06 Daniel Amarty has been withdrawn at halftime and Kiernan Dewsbury Hall comes on in his place. 19-51 Kevin Thalf time at the King Power and it's all square. Villa have played some good stuff at times and look a threat going forward. Most importantly, though, they've been excellent at the back appear capable of shedding this Fox's attack out. 19-26 some nice play by Villa sees Hepburn Murphy trick his way past Benelouane, who brings the young striker down. Villa take a short free kick before Doyle Hayes crosses for Hepburn Murphy to volley wide of the target. It's been a very even opening here at the King Power. 19-13 Daniel Amarty, who was rumored to be on Villa's radar in January, starts for the hosts, as does defender Johan Benelouane. 19-11 Villa almost take the lead from what would have gone down as an awful error by Fox's goalkeeper Daniel Iverson. Doyle Hayes collected a short corner and whipped a cross into the goalkeeper's hands but he couldn't hold it and almost dropped it into his own net. Leicester survived though. 19-06 Leicester start brightly and George Thomas heads wide early on. Baisley Graham misses the ball at the back post but it takes the winger by surprise and he can't convert. 19:03, the teams are out and we're about to get underway. Villa are in their all-black away strip and Leicester in their usual blue home kit. 18:50, as expected, Kanon Davis and James Bree are held back ahead of the first team's match with Derby County tomorrow. Both players have been used occasionally by Kevin MacDonald this season, but a first-team game tomorrow was always likely to see them miss out. Callum O'Hare, Mitch Clark, Jack Clark and Jacob Bodo return after being rested against Norwich on Monday. 18:43, key event under-23's skipper Jordan Lydon insists Villa have got their eyes on the prize tonight, a place in the final. It's going to be a good experience for a lot of the lads who haven't really experienced cup football before. Obviously I have before with the next gen. It's something to look forward to, playing at their main stadium against a very good Leicester side. We know what they're about. It's a massive game, we've got our eyes on the prize, hopefully we can go for the win and get into the final. It's always good to test ourselves against the best. We're looking at getting promoted out, Sevs. Villa provided a bit of early team news today on the official website, and we're expecting the confirmed lineup soon. Callum O'Hare is expected to be involved after missing Monday's defeat to Norwich at Villa Park. He was winded in the previous match against Newcastle. The spine of the team is expected to remain intact, with Matthias Sarkic, Jacob Bodo, Jordan Lydon, Jake Doyle Hayes and Rushi and Hepburn Murphy all available, said the bulletin on the club website. Hello and welcome to our semi-final coverage. The Young Lions won't need any lifting for tonight's clash at Leicester, but they have received some words of encouragement from Steve Bruce. The club have an excellent sprinkling of talent in the U23's squad. They've got a big game tonight at Leicester and on Tuesday at Villa Park against Reading. Let's hope they can progress, because they've had a great season so far. If they can get to the next level, Premier League 2 Division 1, that would be terrific.